Did you know your Yamaha can sing? So these are basically, the only tools that you're gonna need to get that job done. You will need your regular your Allen wrench that you use to get the most of the stuff out on your bike. You know, it fits all over the place. Fits here, fits there. So this is the Allen wrench that you need. Then you're gonna need the smaller one to remove your tank speedometer thing. Then you will need, this one is a very special one. This is a 5mm one. If you don't have a 5mm, find the one that does not fit into the adjuster screw for the valve clearance. And I don't know if you can see it, but I kind of have it shaved off. I found one that it just slightly too big, so I got it shaved off, and then I would measure it, try to fit it in as snug as possible, so I kind of had it modified. Ideally it would probably be 5mm as far as I'm concerned, but I'm not 100% sure on that. You will need your ratcheting wrench, tool, whatever you want to call it. You will need this guy to drive some things on the angle, because things are kind of complicated, not very easy to get access to. But for the most part, this is going to be your lifesaver. This is a 10 millimeter wrench with the ratcheting end on this side here. This is gonna save your life. So if it's straight like this, it's probably okay. But if it's a little bit angled, like, you know, like this guy here, probably be even better. I'm not sure, but this one works. But this is gonna be your magic right here. So this is the one you want to get. What else? You will need a 10 millimeter socket, 12 millimeter socket to get the seat, to get the tank out, and yeah, I think that's probably all there is. The only purpose it's gonna serve. Oh yeah, it's also gonna have, you'll need it to remove the honker, and to access the valve cover behind the honker. What I would do is I would take this tab that holds the whole horn, and I would just kind of bend it out just a little bit, just enough for me to insert this thing in there and kind of get the screw loose out there on an angle. So that's why you need this. You may also need it for the rear. Well, yeah, you might. I don't know. So, filler gauges. You will need your filler gauges ranging from 0.06 millimeter all the way up to 0.18. Not a whole lot of range. Very little bit of the entire stack that I have here. So get yourself some clearances, because the filler gauges, because the clearances that we're going to be looking at start from 0.07 all the way up to 0.17, and I'm slightly lower and slightly higher on either end. You know, that's basically, you will need a whole bunch of numbers in between. You will see the numbers that I use in the process. I have 0.10, I have 0.8, I have 0.8, 0.010, 0.13, 15, 18, and blah, blah, blah. Okay, those are the tools, and let's get started. I'm not going to be covering the basics. I'm not going to be covering how to remove your tank, how to remove all the covers, how to remove these plastic things. They're just the basic screws that you're gonna remove with your Allen wrench, you know, with the big one. Pop those four things out, and then there's some 10 millimeter bolts right underneath it. It all comes out, and then yeah, not gonna be covering that part, so we'll just get straight to the business. We need to remove this cover, and as you can see, it's not very tight. It's tight, but You can get it loose, and you should tighten it by hand. And by hand, I mean provide a good amount of leverage, and it will be sufficient. And I just gently wiggle it out and push it out. Now you can get that bracket out of the way. You can remove this bracket if it bothers you, but I'm just gonna kind of go out this way. Okay, and there it is. So we'll just remove the cover, set it aside, and I really wish we had a buddy who would spin the motor on the other side, aligning the mark, aligning this mark here. It's actually like there's like a little round thing over there. Don't worry about the black lines. There's actually a circle that needs to be aligned to the top over here, but we're not gonna align it cranking the engine. We're not gonna align it exactly to this line. We're just gonna stop somewhere before, and then we're gonna start looking into the inspection hole to find our top dead center. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna turn the engine just a little bit so I can kind of see where I'm at. It's a little bit difficult, but I can still do it with my left hand watching over. So as I rotate, this is the front cylinder, so don't get confused. Just watch for this hole. There it is, for this circle here. Almost matched, almost. So I know I'm close. Now I go over to this side of the engine and I start looking at my top dead center mark. And I'm just gonna slowly rotate this and looking at this hole, and I'm looking for some kind of mark. Okay, there's my mark right there. Okay, so get that marked aligned with the top of the line of the. There's a little notch over there at the top. You align that mark with that line, and then we go around grabbing our filler gauges. Or we can actually, it really doesn't matter. We can actually do it from whatever side you like. So we're gonna start measuring the inlet. And the inlet's gonna be this side. This is gonna be the inlet for the front cylinder. This is gonna be the inlet for the rear cylinder. Exhaust is back there. And inlet's supposed to be anywhere from 0.7 to 0.12. So I got a few of them here to fiddle around with. So I'm gonna try number 10, 0.010, 0.1 millimeter, 1/10 of a millimeter. And I'm gonna shove it in into here, and that does not fit. Okay, so we're gonna go smaller. I want to go smaller. I have a small 0.6, 0.8, 0.08. There we go. And I try to insert it there. Okay, so 0.8 doesn't fit, so that means I go smaller, 0.6 maybe. Let's try 0.6. See if that fits. Nope. I don't know if you can see it where I'm trying to shove it in. I'm just trying to shove it in between the adjuster screw. Okay, so that one doesn't fit. What's the next size? 0.6, 0.05. I think this is the smallest one I have available. 0.05. That. Okay, so 0.05 does fit, and I can feel a little bit of drag. You see, I'm not forcing this, but it kind of goes in there. So that means our clearance is 0.05, and we need to be at least 0.07, which means we are a little too tight. So, and then in order to increase this, all we gotta do is we have to loosen up the nut up on top here,
And then there's an adjuster screw, which is just a regular 5 millimeter Allen wrench. And then we're gonna turn it very, very gently. I'm gonna loosen it up, turning it this way. Okay, so let's do that.
Okay. So I'm gonna grab my 10 millimeter wrench for the nut. And let's loosen this nut, turning it this way while holding the adjuster screw. Okay, so we got that loose just a little bit. Now let's increase the gap. And increase the gap, we turn the adjuster screw the same direction. Very little bit. So watch just the amount of turn. Very little. Now we tighten it back down. And now you can go ahead and measure. So let's see if the 0.6 would fit. Okay, let's see, there we go. And it seems like it doesn't fit, but what I really want to do is I want to rotate the engine at least one time until I hit that same top dead center. And then I will recheck the clearance. Okay, so I rotated the engine. And then I'm going to recheck again. Okay, so the 06 fits. Let's try the 08. Remember, we want to be from 0.07 to 0.12. So the 08 doesn't fit. So that means we're somewhere in between the 06 and the 08. Probably 07 still a little too tight. Let's loosen it up some more and get that range. Turn it. Turn the adjuster screw in the same direction just a little bit more. Tighten it back down. And now let's rotate the engine one more time. Make a complete revolution. Set to the top dead center mark again. A good practice would be to turn to crank the engine at least twice. So I want the 08 to fit. And it does. So let's go ahead and do 010. I want the 08 to fit, but I don't want the 010 to fit. So if the 010 fits too easy, and if it doesn't, so that means this one's perfectly fine. So that means it's a 09, which is not 07 or 12. 10 would be ideal. I mean, if I can go crazy, I could probably do that, but the 09 is probably fine. But I'm a little crazy, you know, I want it perfect. So I will rotate this one more time until I get my filler gauge of 0.1 fit. Top dead center mark. Okay. Let's try 0.1. Okay, there we go. And it doesn't go. So let's go back to 0.8 to double check. And maybe I'll just leave it at 0.8. Yeah, it goes a lot easier. So it's like a 0.9 right there. So yeah, I'm just gonna leave that one alone. So this guy is done. I can go ahead and close the valve. So, because we're done adjusting that one. And now we'll repeat the same thing for the exhaust while we're still in that same position. We don't need to change anything right now. We don't need to crank the engine at this moment. We can just go ahead and start checking the exhaust clearance. Exact same headache on the exhaust side. We need the clearance of 0.12 to 0.17, so anywhere from 0.14, 0.15 is probably going to be a perfect center, a perfect sweet spot. So that's what I'm going to be shooting at. And it's a little bit tricky down here, but it still can be managed. So I got the 0.8 fits, and I need something between, something about 0.13 to see. Okay, 0.14, that's 13. 15. If I get 15 not fit, but the 13 fit, that means I'm somewhere about 14. So the 15 does fit. 18 is gonna be maximum, and the 18 does not fit. So that means we're like 16, 17 maybe. So we're already at the max on this one. So let's go ahead and our gap, we need to tighten this gap this time, not to get it loosened. So this is a little bit tricky here. So I'll insert the adjuster Allen wrench. We'll get that thing loose. Come on. Okay, and then we're just gonna, right now we're gonna tighten it. It's making the gap smaller. So I'm gonna turn a very small amount. Okay. And without any further ado, I'm just going to crank the engine, set it to the top dead center, and then remeasure. All right. Okay, so the top dead center is set. Let's double check. Clearance here. Okay, so the 18 does not fit. So that's good. Let's go. So we need 12, from 12 to 17. Let's see, 15. Let's see if 18 does not fit. 15 does not fit. If the 13 fits, and it does not, it kind of goes in the rear rough. I didn't want to force it, but that means I tightened it too much. So we will reinsert our thing, loosen up that screw, and then fall back a little bit and retighten it back. Okay, there. So we can probably check if we have any success. The 15 should not fit. The 13 might fit. And we'll, yeah, 13 does fit, but we'll not be 100% sure unless we crank the engine. Check again for the 15. Sorry about my head being in the way. 15 does not fit. What about 13? 0.13. The 13 does get fit very loosely. So I'm assuming we're somewhere around 14. And I'm gonna open up that gap just a little bit more because I wanted to be at 15. I'm a little crazy like that. Okay, just a little tiny turn. Tighten it back down. And let's see if the 13 still fits. And it looks like something has changed. So I cannot know until I rotate the engine again. Double check again. It's a little tedious walking around checking for stuff. So the 13 goes in there very easy. And where's my 15? Okay, there's my 15. Let's see if I can squeeze this one in. All right, the 15 goes and there's a little bit of drag. So we're good on that one. All right.
Thing for the rear cylinder, this little dot needs to align with this little notch here. But so as you rotate, don't align that first, but rather look into the hole, and then you're gonna start. You want to find the two notches over there, and okay, so the two notches are indicating that we are just about to set the top dead center for the cylinder number two, which is the rear one. So, and as you can see, we're not quite there, but that's okay. It's okay if it's not quite there, so that the two lines are indicating that we're getting close. So slowly progress, and then there's your T1. I don't know if you can see it. You should probably see it. There's your T1 mark, lined up with the notch at the very top. And now we go in and we do our measurements exactly the same way we did with the front cylinder. We measure the front and the back, and we're trying to match it up with the exact same specs.
That's it for the valve adjustment. I hope you guys found this video helpful. Give me a thumbs up if you want. Don't really care. If you're a believer in God, say a prayer for me once, please. And if you're not, well, you better be safe, because you're not a believer. You're just ignorant. You're just ignoring that God's there. Makes your life a lot easier that way. Well, thank you for watching anyway. God bless you. Have a good day.